Hi, I'm Jonathan, this is BrainStuff, and today we're talking one-way mirrors, aka two-way mirrors, aka transparent mirrors. You know, those things you see in a crime drama when one cop's interrogating a suspect while another watches through a window that appears, from the suspect's side, to be a mirror. It's not magic. TV cops aren't wizards. Except sometimes they are. But that's fiction. And transparent mirrors are science, specifically material science and optics. A regular old mirror, the kind hanging over your bathroom sink, is a sheet of glass holding up an extremely thin layer of reflective metal. The metal comes in the form of a metallic salt, which can be dissolved in liquid and sprayed onto the glass in a process called silvering. That's because silver nitrate was the first stuff used for this process. These days, most mirrors are actually silvered with aluminum, which is cheaper and sturdier. But silvering doesn't make perfect mirrors. They reflect most light, but a little is still transmitted through infinitesimal gaps in the reflective metal layer. So everyday mirrors receive an opaque backing, like dark paint. This stops cold any photons that slip through the metal layer and protects it from scratches. Without the backing, you'd be able to faintly see the wall behind the mirror. But what if you purposefully made a mirror imperfect? Manufacturers of transparent mirrors spray an even thinner, less dense layer of silvering onto the glass, meaning it reflects less light. For example, let's say half the light of an ordinary mirror. The rest passes straight through the glass like it's a window, which it is. A transparent mirror with its sparse silvering and lack of backing is just a very reflective window. And it's a window from both sides. So, how come the suspect sees his reflection, but the cop sees the suspect? It's a trick of the light. The observer room is kept dark, while the observee's room is lit up like the Vegas Strip. So on the cop's side, more light is coming through the glass than being reflected from the room. And from the suspect's side, more light is reflecting from the room than being transmitted through the glass. It's similar to how when late at night and you have all the lights on, you can't really see out your window, but someone outside could see into your house. And hey, people ask about this a lot. If you ever want to test a mirror to see if it's transparent, block the light around you and try to peer through. A bright flashlight can help illuminate anything that might be behind the mirror. That's all we have time for today, but I want to know, what's your favorite magic or haunted mirror? Tell me in the comments. If you like this video, make it official and subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Oh, and for lots more brainy stuff, check out our internet website, brainstuffshow.com.